from a microphone here. Keep moving this thing around so I can find a convenient spot for it to get that button. All right, so we're going to do baptism, right? And the thing about baptism is a lot of churches point out the fact that it is an outward sign of an inward change. That is most certainly true. It is also more than that. If you have a bulletin, or if you remember the words that you just sang, to baptize into your name most holy, one of the things that is often overlooked about baptism is the fact that in baptism, God acts, not just the individual coming forward to be baptized. In fact, this is the place in which he claims us as his own, he marks us as his children, as heirs with Christ of the kingdom of God, forgives our sins, and it becomes the point at which we can locate in time and place a specific reception of the Holy Spirit. Not that the Holy Spirit isn't bringing faith before in the case of an adult baptism, but that is what's happening in baptism. That's why for the Lutheran Church, it's a sacrament. It's something that's a little bit more than a mark of one's change. It is a mark of what God is changing in your life. So I'm going to invite Paul forward, and I'm also going to invite you to follow along in the hymnal. Many of you were baptized as adults, but many of you were also baptized as children and do not remember this. So while this is a more updated version, we'll stand right here, please. I usually hide in the corner, but you can do that today if you want to. You may not remember the words that were spoken over you at your baptism. So by turning to page 268 and following along, you can reflect on these things as Paul and I do the rite of baptism. And so I better turn to page 268 too, so I know what I'm doing. Here we go. Always helps, doesn't it? And so we begin today in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Dearly beloved, Christ our Lord says in the last chapter of Matthew, "All authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." In the last chapter of Mark, our Lord promises, "Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved." And the Apostle Peter has written, "Baptism now saves you." The Word of God also teaches that we are all conceived and born sinful and are under the power of the devil until Christ claims us as his own. We would be lost forever unless delivered from sin, death, and everlasting condemnation. But the Father of all mercy and grace has sent his Son, Jesus Christ, who atoned for the sin of the whole world, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. And so you'll notice that whenever God uses anybody in the Bible for a specific purpose, he changes their name. What we do in baptism, we call that the christening. So this sounds like a silly question, especially for a grown man like Paul. But the very first question of our baptismal rite is, how are we redeemed by Christ the crucified? Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, according to your strict judgment, you condemned the unbelieving world through the flood. Yet according to your great mercy, you preserved believing Noah and his family, 8 souls in all. You drowned hard-hearted Pharaoh and all his host in the Red Sea, yet led your people Israel through the water on dry ground, foreshadowing this washing of your holy baptism. Through the baptism in the Jordan of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, you sanctified and instituted all waters to be a blessed flood and a lavish washing away of sin. We pray that you would behold Paul, according to your boundless mercy, and bless him with true faith by the Holy Spirit, that through this saving flood, all sin in him, which has been inherited from Adam, and which he himself has committed since, would be drowned and die. Grant that he be kept safe and secure in the holy ark of the Christian church, being separated from the multitude of unbelievers, and serving your name at all times with a fervent spirit and a joyful hope, so that with all believers in your promise, he would be declared worthy of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We now skip over to page 270 because Paul can speak for himself. He does not require sponsors, although you are certainly welcome to serve as his surrogate sponsors and pray for him as he begins this journey. So, I'm going to address you as Paul, as that'll be your name. Paul, do you renounce the devil if so say yes?
Yes.
Do you renounce all his works if so say yes? Do you renounce all his ways if so say yes?
Yes.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, if so say yes?
Yes.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried? He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. If so, say yes.
Yes.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting? If so, say yes.
Yes.
Paul, do you desire to be baptized? If so, say, I do. I don't know why they put that in there, but they do. At this point, it's obvious. So, I'm going to use this here. If you'll lean forward just a tad, please. Richard Paul Roberts, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. So I'll give you this. Little mementos like this can help. We normally give these to the kids, but you might find it useful. It's a baptismal candle. This date is now your baptismal birthday. You've been born twice now. You're born once physically from your mom. You're born twice now of the Holy Spirit. So you can remember, put that on a cake or something. I don't know. You can. That's literally what we do. In our family, we light this thing for the kids' baptismal birthday, and we have a sheet cake. You know I've got the sheet cake, but that's what we do. Here is a certificate suitable for framing, although I keep mine in the safe deposit box. That's how I can remember I was baptized on January 31st, 1971, because I obviously wasn't old enough to remember that. But that's if you ever have any questions or anybody does, that's a certificate. And welcome, welcome to the family of believers. So please welcome Paul. You may go back to your seat now. Congregation, let us pray. Almighty and most merciful God and Father, we